Good morning, students. This is KG Mishra with the next topic of physics of chapter electric potential and capacitance of class 12. Okay. See, in the last class, what we have done, that is in last video. In last video, we have done that corona discharge. Okay. That means how the pointed end of a conductor used to discharge the charges or leak the charges. Okay. And second concept that which we have done, that is how the spherical shell, hollow spherical shell used to collect the charges, okay, the collecting action. So now, on the basis of that, we are going to do our topic, which is the last topic of this chapter, obviously, but it is not in your CBSE syllabus, okay, it is not in the board syllabus. Then also we are doing it, okay, and that is called Venn Digraph Generator. This is the name of the device, Venn Digraph Generator, okay. And that is this device. Okay, it may be appearing a complex one, but no, it is not complex. Okay, see, first what we are having a grounded metal base. See, this is the metal base. Okay, till here it is metal. Okay, I can just say it in different way. Metal base. This one is metal base. Grounded means, see, it has been connected to earthing or ground, okay? That's why it is called grounded. Why it is connected to earthing? Because if any charge reaches to this, then it will go to the earth. Okay, it will not remain on this. So it remains always uncharged. Now, above it, what you are having? These two pillars you are having. What is this? This is insulating pillars. Okay, so that whatever charge is here on this sphere, that is not passed to this grounded metal base. Okay, that's why we require this insulating pillars. Getting my point? Okay, now what you are having here, see, this is a metal cell. This is a metal cell. Spherical metal cell is there. Okay, now at the center of metal cell, what you are having, see, this is pulley P2, and here we are having pulley P1. Okay, these are fixed and they are connected with a belt. This is insulating belt to carry and deliver charge. This is a belt which carries the charge. It is insulating belt and it delivers the charge. Where it delivers? It carries from here and delivers here. And then after this, you will find there is no charge on it. Okay. So, this pulleys are rotating and this belt is moving like this. Okay. Now, what else we are having? We are having, you see here, HTB. HTB means high tension battery, means battery of very high potential. Okay, and this is connected to this. So you can see this is a pointed one. Okay, pointed one, and it is like a comb, no? But it is not touching the belt. See, it is called spray comb B1, comb B1, comb B2. Okay, it is spray comb and this is collector comb. Both are metallic. Now what happens? See, as this is connected to this, so the charge will move from here. See, it is connected to the positive terminal, so it will get the positive charge, and where the positive charge density will be highest, obviously at the pointed ends, according to corona discharge concept. Okay, now when the charge density is highest at the point, what will happen? From here the charge will leak and will reach to this non-conducting belt, because what it will do, it is positive charge, so it will take the electron from there, belt, and belt will become positively charged. Okay, so, and belt is moving, so this positive charge will reach here. Now, as the positive charge will reach here, what will happen? You know, always in case of a hollow spherical conductor, charge always moves on the outer surface. Whatever is the potential outside, doesn't matter. If the potential is high also outside, doesn't matter. Charge will always move outside. That's what we have studied. Okay, so this comb will take the charge from here and will send to the outer surface of this spherical cell. Okay, and this process continues, and we will have a very high potential developed over here, positive potential. Okay, so this it's what it does actually, it creates a very high potential. Okay, and what is the use of this high potential? See, here we are having a discharge tube. You can see discharge tube. And in discharge tube, what you have here? We are having ion source. It can be alpha particle, okay. It can be a proton, okay. It can be any positively charged ion, okay. Now, here what we are having a target. So, what happens? This is positively charged particle. When high potential is developed here, then what will happen? This, due to this high potential, it will get a high potential energy. As it will get high potential energy, it will be repulsion, it will move faster, okay. It keep on accelerating, and so it will become very high. So, it will become high energy particle and will go and collide with this target. This is generally used in modifying the lattice of the solid substances, okay. In chemistry, but studying the solid state is there, no, and that it is utilized in that field, okay. Now, how to write this? Working out, explained, you can write it very well, okay. But now, what is the working principle? See, it is based on two principles. First, corona discharge principle is there, okay. Here, second one is whenever the charge is given to a conductor, spherical conductor, okay, hollow spherical conductor, then it reaches to the surface of the spherical conductor, however high the potential may be, okay. So this is the working principle, okay. Clear? Written? Okay. And you can write it by yourself, by understanding. Just draw the diagram and write it down. Okay. I write its working principle, okay. Start writing. Working principle of Venti graph generator. Working principle of Venti graph generator. Working principles of Venti graph generator are, first one, corona discharge. Corona discharge. Second one, collecting action of hollow spherical conductor. Written? Okay. So we have written the working principle. Now working, I have explained to you, you can write it by yourself. Okay. Uses, I have told you, it is used to accelerate the positively charged particles like alpha particle, proton or cations, okay. And it is used in on the deformation of the lattice, okay, structure of the substances, okay, and that is the use of it, okay. Now let us take up the question, okay. See, these are the plates, okay, four plates are there, they have got equal area A, and the separation between the plates is D, and there is air between the plates, okay. Now the question is that what is the capacitance of this system? Now see, when there is air between the plates, then the capacitance, suppose, see, there are two terminals, no? If this is positive, then this is negative, okay. If this is positive, then obviously this plate is positively charged plate, this is negatively charged plate. So this is one capacitor, and see, this is also connected to the same, so it is also negatively charged. So between negatively charged plate and negatively charged plate, it cannot be a capacitor, okay. So this is not a capacitor, this is a capacitor, and what about this? This is negatively charged. And this one is positively charged. So this is a capacitor. Okay. So we have got two capacitors in this arrangement. Okay. But people may get confused as if it is three capacitors are there. No. There are only two capacitors and both are alike. Now, if what is the capacitance of one? We can write it as C naught is equals to epsilon naught A by D, because separation is D, plate area is A, and space between the plates is having free space or air. Okay. Same will be the capacitance of this part also, that is C naught is equals to epsilon naught A by D. Now what you see in both the capacitors, their positive plates are connected together and negative plates are connected together. When this happens, obviously this happens only when there are two capacitors like this, their positive plates are connected together and negative plates are connected together. Suppose this is positive plates and these are negative plates, they are connected together, then they are in parallel combination. So here we have to use parallel. In parallel, what we do? We used to add them. That is 2C naught, and that is equals to 2 epsilon naught A by D. That is the capacitance of this combination. Okay, just note it down. I hope understood. Okay. Let us take up the another question. Okay. See, same plates are there. No, area is A, separation is D. Just there is a little bit a difference in the arrangement. Okay. What do you find? See, suppose this is positive and this is negative. So this is positively charged. This is negatively charged. Okay. This is connected to this is positively charged. And this is negatively charged. Now, how many capacitors you are having here? See, positive negative plates, one capacitor, positive negative plates, two capacitor, positive negative plates, three capacitor. Okay. Now, air is there between the plates. So, what is the capacitance of first one? That is C naught is equal to epsilon naught A by D because separation is D. Okay. And same is the capacitance of second and same is the capacitance of third. See, all these three capacitors, positive plates are connected together and negative plates are connected together. That means this is the case. This is the case. Positive plates are connected together of all the three capacitors and negatives are connected together. Okay, so all are in parallel combination. So what we can do? We can straight away write net capacitance will be 3 C naught. And that is 3 epsilon naught A by D. Okay. So just little bit change in the pattern can change the question. Okay. Okay. See, actually, these are the two plates of a capacitor. Okay. And these are the two rigid supports. And this is a rigid rod. Okay. With which or a rigid support is there which is supporting this plate. Okay. This plate cannot move at all. Now, on this plate, suppose this is plate B and this is plate A, okay. Area of both the plates is A, okay. Separation is this, whatever separation is there initially, okay. Now, what happens? A charge plus Q is given to this and minus Q is given to this. Now, the spring constant of this spring is K. Once you give the positive charge to this and negative charge to this, what will happen? This cannot move because this is fixed. But this can move because spring is there. So there will be attraction between them. Okay. If the force of attraction is F, then what we can write? F is equals to, due to that attraction, what will happen? The spring will get extended. Okay. This plate will move towards it. And suppose it has moved by amount X, then what we can write? F is equals to Kx. Okay. That's what we can write. Or we can write minus Kx. Okay. Now, see, when charges are given, then what will happen? What is the potential energy stored in the capacitor? That we want to find out. Okay. First, let us know what is the capacitance. Okay. Okay. Now, as this plate has moved here, okay. Now, let the separation between the plates is R. Area of the plates is A. So, what is the capacitance? C is equals to epsilon naught A by R. That is the capacitance of that capacitor. Okay. Its potential energy can be given by U is equals to U no half Q square by C. Okay. Now from here, what we can write? Q is the charge given to the plates. Okay. C we can put from here. What will get? Half Q square upon C. C is epsilon naught A. That's what we look at. Potential. Okay. This is the potential energy stored in this capacitor. Now, we know a concept. What is that concept? Let me tell you. We know that potential is equal to work done. That means we write potential is equal to work done. And what is work done? Work done is equal to F dot dr. If we are removing this integration sign, what we can write? Du is equals to F dr. From here what we can write? F is equals to du by dr. Okay. This du by dr we can write. Okay. So from here only there is a relation. Okay. F is equals to du by dr. But my dear children, when this force is attractive, then here you will get a minus sign. If force is repulsive, then here you will get a plus sign. Just note it down. So what we will get? We can write that F is equals to minus du by dr. Okay, agree? So u is this much, half q square r epsilon naught a. We have to differentiate with respect to r. So what we will get? This minus sign is there. Okay. This half is constant, will remain as it is. Okay. Q is constant, q square will come here. Epsilon naught a. What you will get? D by dr of this r. So what is the differentiation of r with respect to r only? It is 1. So what you will get? F is equals to minus q square by 2 epsilon naught a. That's what you will get. Okay. Now, this is the force we are getting. But what spring force we have already got? That is F is equals to minus kx. In this question, actually, we have to find out the extension produced in the spring. Now, can we find out? Very easily. Both the forces are similar, same force, so we can equate them. The minus minus will cancel out. We will have kx is equals to q square by 2 epsilon naught a. And this will implies that this k will come here. We get x is equals to q square by 2 epsilon naught ka, small k, ka. This k is a spring constant, remember that. Okay, so we got the expression for elongation in the spring. Okay, so that, okay, so that's all for this video. Okay, from the next video we'll start the next chapter, and that is electric current. Okay, that is third chapter of NCERT. Okay, tell them, take care of yourself and keep on studying. Okay, bye bye my children.